Hey guys, welcome back. This is HK with TechWrapped, and now in this video, let's talk about the official Pixel Experience ROM based on Android 9 Pie for OnePlus 6. About the ROM installation, you need to download these 4 files. First is the BlueSpark TWRP image, second is the TWRP installation zip, third is the ROM package with G apps included, and the fourth is the Majestip file for routing. Prior to installing this ROM, I was running the Pie version of the OxygenOS, so this guide may or may not work if you are currently running OxygenOS based on Oreo 8.1.0. Okay, first you need to have bootloader unlocked on your phone, then boot to the fastboot or bootloader mode by holding volume up and power button simultaneously, or by typing this command, which is adb space reboot space bootloader within the command prompt screen. You can get this command prompt screen by holding shift key on keyboard and right click on mouse within the folder which contains the platform tools and select open command window or PowerShell here. Next, copy the twrp.img file to this folder, connect your phone to the PC, and within PowerShell type fastboot space boot space name of the twrp file.img and press enter. We use this command to temporarily boot our phone to the twrp recovery. So once you are in the recovery screen, transfer the ROM file, Majestip file and TWRP installation zip file to your phone. If for some reason you are unable to transfer or see these files within TWRP, go to the Wipe tab on home screen, Format Data and type Yes to continue. Do note that by doing this, the entire internal storage of your phone gets wiped, so take a backup first. If you are able to transfer and see these files within TWRP, there is no need to format your phone. Simply go to Wipe tab, Advanced Wipe, select all partitions except internal storage and swipe to confirm wipe. Now comes the ROM installation part. In order to do this, go to Install tab, select the Pixel Experience ROM zip file and swipe to confirm flash. Once the ROM flashing is done, go back to the home screen, Install tab again, select the TWRP installation zip and flash it. So now we have installed the ROM and also made the recovery permanent. Next step is to flash the Majestip file for routing. Installation process is same as installing the ROM zip, but I'm gonna do it after rebooting to the recovery once again. So that's it, we are done with the installation part. There is no need to flash the OpenGApps package as the ROM has it by default. Okay, now I am rebooting my phone to the system, and for the first time the ROM reboots twice before it reaches the Google splash screen, and it took me 1 minute 30 seconds to get to the ROM initial setup. So the initial boot is done without any errors. First let me check the details of the OS, going to the settings, system tab, about phone, the Android version is 9 Pie, security patch level is of October 5, build date is October 20, and the ROM is based on PBR2, the second Pie public release. About the ROM features, the launcher is the Pixel launcher, you have Google search bar at the bottom with a dedicated Google Assistant button, there is Google search screen on the left, and this is the app drawer. As you can see, there is a search bar here too but at the top, and you can also see the app shortcuts within the app drawer. This is the new notification panel and quick toggle menu with Android 9 Pie, setting panel with search bar at the top. Going to the network and internet tab, the ROM supports dual band Wi-Fi, and about the mobile networks, the ROM supports 2G, 3G, 4G, VoLTE and LTE Plus is also supported as you can see, but the ROM lacks native video calling support. Next you have connected devices tab where you can connect to Bluetooth or NFC device, no issues with the pairing, also there is no issue with mic or earpiece while attending calls via Bluetooth. Next, the same apps and notifications tab, except that now you have time spent in apps tab, which is a sub feature of digital well-being. Next, battery tab, you have automatic battery saver from 5 to 75%, battery manager where you can limit battery for apps that you don't use often, and the battery stats for the ROM are also available. If you ask me about the ROM battery life, it is kind of comparable to open beta builds. It is fine, and with medium usage, the battery can last easily for a day. Regarding the charging, the ROM supports dash charging as you can see the lock screen status, and the ampere charging rate also matches with the stock OxygenOS ROMs. Next we have the display tab, adaptive brightness and nightlight are working fine, rest everything is the same, but when you open the ambient display tab, you can find an additional option to enable always on display. The UI is simple and eye-pleasing, and it has information about time, notification icons, and some other stats. This is a nice feature, especially for phones with AMOLED displays, and the battery consumption is also much lesser compared to the phones having IPS screens. Under device theme, you have three themes just like any other ROM: automatic, light, and dark. Light theme works fine, but the dark theme has issues. Whenever you select the dark theme or use a dark wallpaper with automatic mode, the quick toggle background changes to light red instead of black or gray. Also, within the display tab, you can find the double tap to wake the screen feature, and it works great. Next, we have the sound tab. Everything is the same, but one change here is that now you can select the media output device when you connect your phone to the external devices. Next, storage tab, security and location tab. FP sensor works fine for screen unlocking, but it is slightly slower compared to the OxygenOS based ROMs. There is no face unlock like stock OxygenOS, but you can add trusted face via smart lock, and swipe up on lock screen is needed to unlock your phone. Under digital well-being, you have information about the apps you use. There's window on feature which turns the entire screen to gray, manage notifications, and also enable and customize do not disturb mode. Finally, under system gestures tab, enable swipe up on home button to get the Pi gestures. I haven't tried custom launchers, but with the included launcher, the Pi gestures work great. Swipe up once to open recents, long swipe to get to the app drawer, hit on the pill to go to home, and you can also use the pill as a slider to switch between the recently opened tabs. Swipe up on a tab to close it, swipe down to open it, and to clear all the open tabs, swipe all of them to the right and hit the clear all button. Regarding the other things about the ROM, the video playback is fine, be it with YouTube or any other external player, but the YouTube app doesn't support full screen mode, which means whenever you zoom in on any video, part of the video screen gets cut by the notch. The camera app we get with the ROM is a very basic one. It doesn't have any extra features like portrait or manual modes, but you can install the OnePlus OxygenOS camera app, which can take pictures, videos at a resolution of 1080p or 4K at 60fps. Portrait mode works fine for the selfie camera, but when you open the portrait mode for the rear camera, the camera app crashes. Pixel 3 Google camera port is also working with the ROM, including the portrait mode for both rear and selfie cameras. Another thing that is not working with both OnePlus and Google camera apps is the slow motion video recording. All the sensors are working fine, as you can see: accelerometer, magnetic field, orientation, gyroscope, light, proximity, GPS, everything is working just great. And finally, about the performance of this ROM, this is undoubtedly one of the smoothest custom ROM based on Android Pie. I have tried it on OnePlus 6. Also, I was very surprised to know that how good this ROM performs with PUBG, and I did not notice any difference with PUBG gameplay compared to the Pie open beta builds. If you care about the benchmarks, Sentinel 2 version 7 score is 282052, and with Geekbench 4 single core score is 2354 and multi-core score is 8901. So all in all, this is a very stable ROM with stock pixel look and features, and it can also be used as a daily driver if video calling is not a necessity for you. That's all folks, hit like and subscribe if you find this video helpful. Thanks for watching, I'll see you guys next time.